let me start off the show quickly by giving you this piece of news. It's good news. And that's because on Monday, we started talking about this. On Monday, we started raising an awareness about all of this. And we are so happy to announce to you that it is ending well. We started it on Monday, and on Friday, we have good news for you. It's about our wrestlers. On Monday, remember, we talked about the Golden Grand Prix in Azerbaijan, a tournament for Olympic medalists, for continental champions across the world, and the need for our wrestlers to participate in that event to avoid sanctions and to avoid a blacklist from international competitions. But the good news is that, yes, our athletes went there, and guess what? Odunayo Adekuroye. I'm sure by now you are so familiar with that name. Odunayo Adekuroye went all the way, and this afternoon she won gold for Nigeria by beating our opponent from Russia, Nina Menokova, 12-2. It was so convincing. Before she won in the finals, she had already beaten her opponent in the semifinals 10-0. Fantastic performance by Odunayo Adekuroye. Not so good for Aminat, who crashed out in the earlier rounds. But at least we went to Azerbaijan, we saw, and we conquered, courtesy of Odunayo Adekuroye. I'm sure Daniel Igali must be a very happy man. Not just Daniel Igali, all those who rallied around and ensured that this lady and the other wrestlers did not miss out of the competition in Azerbaijan, in Baku, Azerbaijan, the Golden Grand Prix event. All right, so that's so comforting, so gladdening, and once again, it shows how close you could be sometimes to achieving success, and how sometimes little things could tend to frustrate you. But then if you're able to walk outside of all those distractions, you could be striking gold. And that's the story of Odunayo Adekuroye. All right, so that's very, very gladdening for us because of the campaign we started to launch from the beginning of the week, yielding results for these wrestlers. All right.
Well, thanks for having me, Tony. It's heartwarming. It's good. We've always known Odunayo to be a medal prospect. Things didn't go our way at the Olympics. And, I mean, just the way you have rightly put it, the difference between winning and not winning might just be tied down to some factors that, if well handled, you know, the difference could just have been Odunayo standing on the podium. And from someone that was almost not going to Azerbaijan, and eventually going and not allowing all the drama that played out, you know, affect her, and going on to post that kind of
impressive
performance, it's commendable. And it just brings us back to what we say about taking care of all the things that these sportsmen and women worry about. If we can take care of the distraction, they'll always do us proud. And I'm very happy. I'm very happy. We missed the opportunity with the way we prepared for the Olympics, because a lot of us still feel that this lady should have been gotten us a medal. But it didn't happen. I'm hoping that we'll get it right in subsequent competitions. Get her, you know, get her in shape, put her in competitions, and ensure that she's active. And of course, you do that for an athlete. They'll be inspired, and of course they will deliver. For the junior ones, I'm always happy. You know, when you start facing the disappointments at the tender age, it tends to make you get scarred somewhat. And I'm happy that the young ones are not getting scarred at the early age, because if you ask battle-hardened veterans like Toriola and Kodri, they will have unpleasant tales. They will
have stories of challenges, overcoming challenges.
Well,
it's become a way of life
on one
if you're
side,
a Nigerian sportsman
on one
or
side,
woman.
On one side, and the unpleasant stories too, on the other side.